Das Kapitel, glaube ich, zu Ende, oder?
Ja.
Act 4. Motion. Motion.
Capture.
Motion capturing of Amy with no legs.
Dü-düm.
Dü-düm. Ja, ich glaube, ich muss mal aufstehen. Ja, ich glaube, wir stehen mal auf. Hey, war heute was Wichtiges? War heute irgendwas Wichtiges? Ich glaube nicht, oder?
Nee, oder?
Nee. Ich glaube, wir schlafen einfach weiter, ja. The morning sun is bright through my open window and the sound of my alarm quickly has me up and about. I slept surprisingly well last night, secure in the knowledge that at least I've got another chance with Amy. If I can just keep myself from doing anything stupid, maybe I'll find out what's been eating her recently.
Was? Er will sie essen?
Naja, Liebe geht durch den Magen bekanntlich, oder?
Stimmt, wo du es sagst.
Ja. I have a few educated guesses, guess, es klingt wie guess, aber es ist ja das andere guess. Naja, but nothing
concentrate, du willst es sagen.
Ich wollte es eigentlich sagen. Concentrate. Das ist Konzreter. And certainly nothing but I am going to say it to her. I'd much prefer to have her tell me herself. Amy is waiting for me as promised, looking a little haggard, a little haggard, but otherwise bright and cheerful, much more so than any previous days this week.
Hey, sir, you're late!
I wave my hand, dismissively. Nonsense! You're just early, bitch!
Bitch.
Amy grins back and it feels like we're finally back where we should be with one another. Except now Amy's not just me, wants to take another step forward. Or thought a part of me worries that she'll back out at the last second.
Hurry up and stretch, sir. I don't want to miss the bus.
The bus?
Yeah, the bus. I want to show you something and I don't want to be late.
Oh, okay. I try not to grin too wide. I'm happy beyond words that Amy wants to hang out after the run at all, but her promise of showing me something has me even more intrigued. Is this what she had to think about? I wonder just what she's planning to do. I quickly go through my warm-up routine while Amy bounces impatiently from one foot to the other. She really does seem to want to get moving as soon as
halt, possible. Stopp! Das Gesicht war so süß, du solltest nicht einfach skippen.
Ich hab's mir noch nie mal angeguckt.
Ja, es war süß. Ich wollte halt Stopp vorher sagen, bevor du drückst.
Da hättest du einfach reingerufen. Du kannst bei sowas ruhig reinrufen.
Ja, aber du Gesicht hast gerade so schön vorgelesen und da wir jetzt an einer entspannteren Phase sind, habe ich gedacht...
Ich hab das süße Gesicht nicht gesehen.
Ja. Ha, verkackt.
Ja, wirklich. Schande über mich selbst. The run is over so quickly, I can barely believe that I haven't fallen over dead afterwards. Amy set a blistering pace and I, in my foolishness, kept up with her. Well, until the last few laps, I had to slow down just in case, but I don't mind, and Amy's waiting patiently for me when I finished. As patiently as she can wait, anyway.
Finished? Good. Come on.
Grabbing my arm, she practically rushes me down to the nurse's office.
You seem in a hurry, Amy, trying to catch the early bus. Yeah, I told Mom I'd be back for lunch.
Well, I'll take care of you first, then.
But Hisero's got to come with me too.
The nurse raises a single eyebrow at this statement and peers at the two of us searchingly.
Really? Today?
Amy's response is a nod, followed by a surprisingly shy grin.
Well then, we'll make this quick.
Amy enters the nurse's office and I patiently wait outside for her to be finished, wondering just why the nurse seemed to be surprised by Amy's declaration. I feel like I'm missing out on some joke or the significance of today beyond the fact that it is clearly significant in some way, of course. Alter, fettes Solo. Wow.
Die Musik kennen wir doch schon lange.
Ja, aber gerade ist es halt nochmal so fett, das Solo.
Ja,
Weißt du, so in der letzten Reihe der Typ, der geht voll ab. True to his word, the nurse has Amy out of his office surprisingly quickly and I take her place after promising to meet up at the front gate. The nurse take my pulse and listen for a bit.
Your heart beats faster than usual. Been pushing yourself again, have you?
Well, Amy seemed in a rush to get through the run, so...
I'm not surprised today. It's rather important to her, you know?
I suspected that could be the case, but I have no idea why that's the case. Vielleicht ist ja Tode Stark des Vaters irgendwie geworden oder so.
She hasn't told you? Interesting.
So, you are not going to tell me Aoife, then?
No, I'm not. I suspect that Amy has her own plan for explaining today to you. And I don't want to mess with that. You'll find out soon enough. So that's a rush. Now, as for your heart, I would take it easy. The rest of the day. No spontaneous racists or anything like that. Got it?
Got it. She won't have her running legs on anyway, right?
No, but if you think something like that is going to stop her.
Good point.
I don't think it'll be much for an issue today of all days, but still.
If he's trying to rescue me, must reassure me, he is doing a terrible job. I'm quickly becoming more and more worried about what today could be for. Like suddenly finding out Amy is in a cult or something. Tja, pech gehabt, Homer. At the same time, if today is such a big deal and Amy wants me to be with her for it, then maybe she really does want to grow closer to me. Maybe this will be the answer to all the riddles, to the sleepless nights and the sad mood swings. Either way, I barely remember to thank the nurse before taking off my pants. As quickly as I dare from my room to get a shower and threw on some decent looking clothes. If today is as important as it seems to be, I should dress appropriately. Appropriately. Meine Zunge bricht gleich ab. Amy, of course, proves me wrong as soon as I reach the front gate, wearing her usual skirt and so short, so at least I know it's not a terrible formal affair, whatever it is.
You really, Hiso?
Not as early as you. Eager, are you? Are we? Amy chicly pokes out her tongue. The bus stops isn't very crowded at this hour, which seems to please Amy, and we end up relaxing a little as we wait. We sit in silence for a while, but I can tell that Amy is trying to walk herself up to say something. Haben wir eigentlich jemals einen Schulleiter von dieser Schule gesehen?
Nein.
Eigentlich interessant, weil du siehst doch oft, oder es ist doch eigentlich normal, dass man einen Schulleiter irgendwie in solchen Spielen oder Geschichten mal trifft.
Also in Animes ist das relativ normal.
Deswegen ist mir gerade so aufgefallen. Ist eigentlich kein wichtiges Detail, aber ich sag mal so.
Aber nicht immer. Gucken wir uns einfach mal Planet an.
An sich kommt das Ganze mit sehr wenig Leuten aus. Die ganze Geschichte.
Sie hier erzählen die Geschichte. Aber auch erst ab dem Punkt, wo man sich halt für einen entschieden hat.
Ja. Aber auch lehrermäßig. Anscheinend tut der Klassenlehrer hier fast alles machen. Es gibt nicht irgendwie die Kunstlehrerin, die krasse. Ja, die krasse Kunstlehrerin gibt es zum Beispiel nicht. Oder eigentlich hätte ja auch hier auch unsere Yuko Geschichtslehrerin sein können als Bibliothekarin.
Als schüchterne Geschichtslehrerin. Wer weiß.
Naja, wer weiß. I don't have anything to say myself, so I sit waiting for her to talk. It doesn't take too long.
So, I'm sure you're curious as to why the nurse thought it was too weird for me to be bringing you along today.
I was a bit yes, but if you're not ready to tell me...
Ja, ich war ein bisschen ja.
Ja.
Ich war ein bisschen ja.
Amy stops my sentence by placing a finger on my lips.
Don't tempt me, Hiso. I want to tell you this, but I'm just uncertain as to how to go about it. I don't want to keep delaying or deferring. I just want to be able to say it.
So say it.
You know that is not going to be that easy for me, Hiso.
So treat it like running. Warm up to it with something small and easy and go from there. But don't do it too fast, okay? I'm a patient man. I can wait for you to get to it. Amy seems to consider my words, weighing them against what is probably a desire to get it over with. I will admit it. As much as I keep telling Amy to take her time, I wouldn't mind her getting it over with Eva. But somehow I know that Amy probably needs more time than the bus ride will provide to get it all out, whatever it is.
Yeah, maybe you're right. The bus stop. The bus stop probably isn't the best place for this anyway. But just to make sure that I don't go back on my word, I'll at least say this.
She takes a deep breath, let it out, and after a moment says in a low voice,
"We are going to see my dad today."
The words hang in the air, and I can see that Amy is afraid, that I panic and despair in response, which a part of me almost wants to do. But it would be stupid of me to back out or to suddenly abandon the promise I made to be there for Amy when she needs me. The nurse thought it was so weird of her to bring me along. She doesn't bring anyone along, or at least I'm willing to bet that she hasn't before today. The day seems to take on an even greater significance. What has it taken Amy to even get this far? An dieser Stelle können wir nochmal Wetten abschließen, beziehungsweise so einen Tipps abschließen, ob es nun 1, 2 oder 3 wird. Also, Vater lebt, Vater im Krankenhaus, Vater tot. Ich bin für Vater tot.
Ich auch.
Okay. Ah.
Gut, dass er es auch verstanden hat.
And why is that the best I can manage as a response?
Yeah.
I don't know what I should say.
Nothing, I think. Just promise that you're going to come with me.
Of course. You know I will. Amy smiles vainly, looking a little relieved.
Good. In that case, we'd better get going.
The bus pulls up just a little after she finishes the sentence. Yeah, yeah. Vague memories of my first trip out here come to my mind as I step off the bus, but unfortunately, they are too vague to be of any use. I will be the first to admit that I don't quite recall how to get to Amy's house, so I let her lead the way. She seems content to walk in silence, and myself, I have no idea what I could possibly say, so the two of us arrive at her house, having said nothing since getting off the bus. Amy's mother opens the door and doesn't seem surprised to see me standing next to her daughter. I expect that Amy would have phoned ahead to let her mother know of the change in plans.
Amy, Hiso, you're just in time. Lunch is just about ready. Great, I was afraid we might be running late.
As fast as you were going this morning, I doubt there was much of a chance of that.
I certainly hope she wasn't too much of a bother, Hiso. She tends to get a little paranoid about being on time when food's involved.
I hadn't noticed. This earns me a swat, a swag on the arm from Amy, who, despite the serious nature of our conversation on the bus and the almost brooding, quiet walk that has quickly become cheerful again. Probably to keep her mother from worrying about whatever it is Amy plans to tell me later. Alligator. Mrs. Iberzaki ushers us in, and in short order, we are around the table devouring lunch. I hadn't realized how hungry I was until I got there, but for once I seemed to be eating almost as much as Amy.
Goodness, it's a good thing I ate so much. The two of you are acting like you haven't eaten in days.
I skipped breakfast this morning.
Me too. Had to catch the bus, I assume? That and I figured you'd make too much food, so it wouldn't matter if I skipped breakfast. Well, it's good to know what I'm predictable.
Amy nods and enthusiastic. And conversation falls off again as we very nearly clear the table of anything edible. It is a testament to the sheer amount of food on offer that we don't finish everything. I lean back in my chair with a sigh and thank Mrs. Ibarazaki for the food.
I'm glad you